Hey guys, how are you all doing? If you're new here, welcome. My name is Krazy Ken, and today we're gonna take a quick look at BlueMaxima's Flashpoint, which is a Windows app that allows you to play archived Flash games and animations, and it works with other multimedia platforms too, like Shockwave and Silverlight. Now this is important because now that Adobe is blocking the Flash Player plugin from running, users will have to find other ways to play this archived stuff, and there's multiple ways to do it, but the way I'm familiar with is Flashpoint. All right. Let's dive in. First, go to bluemaxima.org/flashpoint and click download. There's several options here, but the two main ones are Ultimate and Infinity. I recommend using Infinity because it uses less hard drive space and the media files will only save to your computer once you first launch them on demand. Ultimate, on the other hand, doesn't require additional downloads when you launch the media files because everything is already saved to your hard drive. But keep in mind, it's a massive download. It's 478 gigabytes. But for now, we'll stick to Infinity. Once the Infinity installer is downloaded, open the 7Z file from your downloads location, and the contents will self-extract to any location you choose. When the extraction is done, open the Flashpoint folder, double-click on Start Flashpoint, and boom, enjoy the massive library. You can browse the categories across the top of the screen, and I recommend dragging your favorite items into the favorites list so you can access them quicker. And one more quick tip, if you need to access the source files, like a SWIFT file, right-click on any item and choose Open File Location, and the File Explorer will reveal the source file. So that's Flashpoint. Go ahead and download it. The link is in the description. And thank you so much to everybody who contributed to the project and to all archival projects for Flash and Shockwave content everywhere. So go ahead and download that and have some fun. And if you want to have a mega nostalgic time travel trip about the history of the Adobe Flash Player, I did a separate episode on that too, and it's a lot of fun, so go ahead and check that out. And hey, if you like this episode, you know what to do. Thanks for sticking with me. Catch the Krazy and pass it on.